Hello, my learners. How are you all? Hope by the grace of God, you had a lovely weekend. Alright, today we are continuing with our visual lesson or the video lesson on natural science. Last week, we talked about what? Climate, what conditions. And we saw or we know that there are what? How many conditions? Four. And we also saw some activities done under what? Each what? Condition. Today we are going to talk about what? Diversity of what? Matter. Diversity of matter. Identifying and classifying solid, liquid and what? Gas. And our keywords for today, we have what? Matter, solid, liquid and gas. I say we are looking at what? Diversity of matter. Identify and what? Classifying solid, liquid and gas. And our keywords for today, we have matter, solid, liquid and gas. Now, there are many or several what? Materials in our environment. And all these materials have what? Different what? Capacity, or they have what? Different sizes. They are all not what? The same. So now let's consider our keywords. When we say matter, what is matter? When we say matter, what is matter? We say that matter is anything that has mass and can what? Occupy what? Space. Matter is anything that has mass and can occupy space. And when we say solid, solid, they are substances whose particles are what? Closely what? Joined what? Together. They are substances whose particles are closely joined what? Together. And liquid are also substances whose particles are what? Widely what? Joined what? Together. They are not closely joined. They are widely what? Or separated what? Together. And we also have gas. Gas are substances which what? Are widely what? Separated and can be what? Move what? About what? Freely. Now, let's look at some materials that we have. Some materials that we have. Let me use your textbook and let's see. We have what? Water. We have water, pencil, soil, sugar, oil, chalk, porridge, cane cake, stone, milk, smoke, and what? Vapor. And all those substances are what in our environment. Water, I hope you all know water. And I have my what? Cup of water here. This is my cup of water. And we also have pencil. You know pencil. You have been using pencil to write each and every day. You have soil. You know we have been seeing our soil. And we also have sugar. We also have oil. I have my oil also here. This is my oil. And we also have chalk. These are the pieces of chalk. And what? Stone. Alright, now all those substances are not what the same. They have what? Different physical properties. They have different physical properties. So we are going to group these substances into solid, liquid, and gas. And we are going to group the substances we have identified into solid, liquid, and gas. Don't forget our topic is identifying and classifying solid, liquid, and gas. So these substances, as we have seen them, these substances, we are going to group them into what? Solid, liquid, and gas. Now, solid, we have what? The first one we have what? Pencil. Pencil is solid. Why is this solid? Pencil. We have pencil. The pencil is solid. And why is it solid? Alright, before we move on there, let's come to our physical what?
properties of what? Solid. They have fixed what? Shapes. They're solid, they have what? Fixed shapes. They have fixed mass. And we have talked about mass. Mass, we said what they are what? It means what? Weight. The mass, it means what? Weight. Three, they can be what? Lifted and moved what? Around. They can be lifted and moved around. So these are the physical properties of what? Solid. Let's look at liquid. They can flow. They can flow. So anything that you can pour out, that can flow is what? A liquid. They can take the shape of its container. They can take or they take the shape of its what? Container. They have fixed mass. They have fixed mass. And with the gas, we have, you cannot hold them in your hands. Gases, you cannot hold them what? In your hands. Also, they do not have what? Fixed shape. So let's group our materials into what? Solid, liquid, and gas. So we have what? Pencil. And what again? We have chalk. Chalk. We have a stone. Stone. And what again? Book. Good. Book. Alright, with our liquid, what are some of the materials I showed to you? I showed you oil. So oil. What again? Water. What again? Milk. Good. This are also what? Liquid. You can also get what? Petrol. Someone will say, Madam, petrol. Good. Petrol. Someone can say, Madam, what about kerosene? Good. Kerosene is also what? Liquid. Now, let's move to our gas. Now, our gas, we said what? You cannot what? Hold them in your hands. They have no what? They do not have fixed shape. Cannot hold them in your hand. They do not have fixed shape. Let's look here with our picture here. We have smoke. Smoke. Can you hold smoke? No. You can only feel the scent when what? Someone is burning something or there is what? A burning in the what? Air. Vapor. When mommy is cooking, air, there is what? Vapor. We can also what? Air. Air. When the wind is blowing, you feel air what? Around you. And we have what? Bubbles. This is the air. Air. And we have bubbles. We have some small containers that we have some Omo liquid in it with water. You shake it, then you'll be blowing it. Bubbles. Bubbles is also example of what? Gases. Bubble. So the example of gases we have what? Smoke. Vapor. What again? Air. Bubble. Good. So these are the examples of what? Liquid, solid, and what? Gases. So I said that matter is anything that has mass and can what? Occupy space. And can occupy space. If I put this chalk and this container with my chalk placed on my table, it is matter because it is occupying what? A space on my table. With the cup of water, it is also occupying what? A space what? On my table. All the things on my table are occupying space is on my table. So they are all what? Matter. They are all matter. With my book and the oil and everything on this table, all these are what? Materials in our what? Environment. All these are materials in our environment. So we are seeing what matter is. And there are how many states of matter? Three. There are three states of matter. We have the first one, solid, the second one, liquid, and the last one is what?
Gas.
Three states of matter, solid, liquid, and gas. But today we are concerning with what? Identifying and classifying solid, liquid, and gas. But don't forget, I said matter is anything that has mass, weight, and can occupy space. And there are three states of matter, solid, liquid, and gas. An example, pencil, chalk, stone, book, etc. You can name some. Chair, cupboard are examples of solid, liquid, oil, water, milk, petrol, porridge, tea are all liquid. Gas, smoke, vapor, air, bubbles. Someone will say, madam, somebody can flatten it, good, but that one, it's also a gas because you cannot hold it. You can only do what? Smell the what? Scent. Alright, so these are the what? Physical properties of the state of matter. Solid, they have fixed shape, they have fixed mass, they can be lifted and move around. Liquid, they can flow, they can take the shape of its container, they have fixed mass. Gas, you cannot hold them in your hands, they do not have fixed shape. This is the end of our lesson, so we meet again. Bye bye.